weg dicht.
For their
because they do also nowadays all these insurance companies also take care of the wellness part. So wellness part is basically the annual health checks which they do for their employees and their family members. They all come.
Every year there are 100,000 MBBS students coming up. 100,000 MBBS students. Number of PG seats, postgraduate seats, is only 45,000. So every year you have 55,000 MBBS doctors coming out who are not getting a PG seat, who are very good doctors, and who a hospital doesn't necessarily have a job for. So our country has been very super specialist driven. These doctors who are coming out, these 55,000, we should be able to absorb them in good primary care and really help patients not need a super specialist, not get admitted. That should be the goal, and I think the government is trying it. If you see now with the wellness centers, the Ayushman Bharat, all the centers that are being set up, they are not called primary care clinics, they are called wellness centers. So the idea is to use these very good physicians who are coming out, these doctors, and prevent and do a lot more preventive medicine. A lot more preventive medicine is needed in India.
During
the National Skill Development Council, which is a Government of India initiative, and so we've been taking, for instance, 12th standard pass and training them to be nurse assistants. So they get a stipend from us and a stipend from government, then they become trained nurse assistants and then they can work with the nurses. Because as you know, there's also a huge shortage of nurses in India. Now for doctors, we don't have a formal tie with any particular medical college, but a lot of them, when they graduate, because now we are getting known as a primary care hub, a lot of them come while they're either studying for exams or for internships, and then many of them reabsorb into the system. So we want to really be an avenue for MBBS doctors. You don't have to get focused. If I'm not a cardiologist, my life is not made. You should be, there should be a space for these physicians to really grow and have a practice and do preventive care and prevent patients from reaching hospitals full of RX days. The Ayush, you know, they're saying that they can be prevented, and the reason they've done it is because they feel there's a shortage of actually allopathic doctors. In reality, there's not a shortage. It's just that they're all trying either for PG or they go abroad. So what we feel is that these are complementary. So we do have homeopaths who work in our clinics. So things that homeopathic doctors are good at, like allergies, there are certain things I think they treat better than allopathy. So the way we look at it is what they are good at, they can treat. What allopaths are good at, let allopaths treat. Because if you have someone who's not trained in allopathy doing allopathy, you may have challenges. But there are many things the homeopaths are good at. So I, as an allopathic doctor, I send my patients who have, for instance, chronic allergies, there's this thing called pulmonary hypertension and your lung pressure goes up. In allopathy, we have certain meds, homeopathy has certain meds. So I think really the goal should be collaborative.